Hello, and today we are with Ms. Zhanat Kazkenova, who is Head of Division of the Tourism Industry Department, Ministry of Investment and Development of the very beautiful Republic of Kazakhstan.
Yeah.
Good morning to you, Zhanat.
Good morning.
Now, here we are at JATA, the Tourism Expo here in Tokyo, Japan. Is this Kazakhstan's... How many times have you been to this expo before?
Okay, so before, some years ago, we were here, I mean, till 2010, some 10 years. But then we stopped it, and last year we started it again. So for this time, we are second time here, last year and this year.
What are you hoping to get from this exposition?
So, of course, a lot of tourists, because we need the Japanese market, tourist market, it is number one for us. That's why we are here. And of course, we would like to attract people, more and more people to Kazakhstan. Because Kazakhstan, you have been to Kazakhstan, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. Beautiful country.
Kazakhstan, you see, it is a beautiful country. A lot of sites, a lot of interesting places, just attracting people. And we would like to show our country and to say that we are here, we are in the world, and Kazakhstan is Kazakhstan. We would like for people to know what Kazakhstan is.
How many visitors from Japan did you have last year, and how many are you hoping to get this year and next?
So, of course, we have not so many people. It is about 5,000 tourists, but of course, we would like to increase. Slightly, maybe very, so not so fast as we would like, but we so would like to attract more and more people so that it were millions of Japanese tourists in Kazakhstan.
Here at the expo, what parts of Kazakhstan are you promoting most to the Japanese?
So we promote the whole Kazakhstan, but the most, as I know, the most interesting places, it is of course Almaty, Astana, Mangistau, Jambil, so the whole parts of Kazakhstan.
What activities? Is it leisure? Because at the moment, of course, Kazakhstan attracts a lot of investment, a lot of business travellers,
yeah.
Not so many leisure travellers.
Yeah.
In terms of leisure, what do you think would be of interest to leisure travellers from Japan in Kazakhstan?
So, leisure travellers, it is, like I told you, it is mountains in Almaty. It is... I understand that, of course, Tokyo developed very well, but Astana, it is our new young city. It is only 20 years old, but it is you've seen it, and it is growing fast. So, of course, Mangistau, like I told you, it is the western part of Kazakhstan, and there are very beautiful views you can see here. It is very beautiful, and it's very interesting. I mean, ecological tourism, everything is developed, and I mean, it will be very interesting for Japanese.
Now, you're working with the Ministry of Investment and Development,
yeah.
In terms of the tourism industry.
Yeah.
There's a lot that needs to be done. I love Kazakhstan enormously, but there's still a lot of work that needs to be done on the ground in Kazakhstan,
yeah.
With regards to language, getting around,
yes.
Easily, this, that, the other. What are you doing to improve the facilities and the language barriers that some Japanese guests may experience?
Yeah, so now, as we are working, as you told, Ministry of Investment and Development, we are trying to improve our infrastructure. For example, signs to be it in English, not only in Kazakh, I mean in our language, also to be maybe so in different languages of the world. So we are trying and doing our best to improve it, like you told me, because for people, I understand, when you are a tourist, you would like the infrastructure and everything to be like more convenient. And which we are trying to do it, to do the world, for the world, to do Kazakhstan more convenient. I mean, when you come and when you see everything.
For Japanese travelers, what is the visa situation for the Japanese travelers? Do they need a visa?
No,
is there one
no,
on
it is. For Japanese, it is free. I mean, they don't need visa.
They can get a stamp on arrival. How many days do they get?
They have 5 days. 15 days? I mean immigration. When you come till 5 days, you cannot register. But they can stay once 15 days.
And Air Astana, you have one of the best airlines in the region.
Yeah.
Air Astana, what routes do they have connecting Japan to Kazakhstan?
So it is, for now, it is unfortunately from Seoul, from Abu Dhabi, I don't know, but not for this time, not the right connect, I mean the direct connect still, but I guess it will be just in the future, maybe in 1 year, maybe in 2 years.
Of course, we have a lot more than just Japan. There's the whole world that are going to be interested. In terms of the European guests and also guests from Asia Pacific, how is tourism looking? Where is increasing the most for you at the moment? In terms of numbers, which visitor arrivals, where are they coming from? From outside, not Japan, from other areas of the world?
So, of course, it is China, it is Japan, it is Europe. It is so the closest countries, of course, it is Uzbekistan, the former Soviet Union countries also. From Kyrgyzstan, from Uzbekistan, from Russia, of course. Because, as I told you, the market number one, it is Japanese, Chinese, it is Russian market. For Kazakhstan, I mean, for tourism.
In terms of hotels, because of course in Astana there's a lot of hotels opening.
Yeah.
But for me, if I'm honest, Almaty is a little bit more exciting with regards to leisure tourism.
Yeah.
Because there you have the mountains, you have skiing, you have rafting, you have so much to offer. Well, in terms of hotel development in Almaty, what is the situation there?
So, in terms of hotels, we have a lot of different five-star, four-star, two hostels. So it is. It depends on the person. If he would like to stay in five-star hotel, of course we have it. If he wants to stay maybe cheaper or something like that, of course you will find it.
Now next year you have Expo 2017.
Yep.
Very important, of course, because that's the heart, if you like, of Kazakhstan energy.
Yep.
What is the Expo 2017 about? And could you tell us about it, please?
So, Astana Expo 2017, it is... So, now for Kazakhstan, it is the project number one. And we hope, I will just tell you in short, we just hope for more people to come and to know, as I told you, Kazakhstan. And Astana Expo, so I hope that it will help us to promote Kazakhstan, to change some of the situation for tourists. There will be more than 3,000 events, cultural, different ones. So a lot of things will be there, will happen. And I invite everybody in the world to Astana Expo 2017.
How many people are you expecting to attend Expo 2017?
About 5 million people, visitors. I hope and I believe that it will happen.
That's the target?
Yeah.
And how many visitor arrivals did you have in 2015?
About 7 million people.
About 7 million.
Yeah.
So you're hoping to boost the normal arrivals by 5 million just for the Expo?
Yeah. Hopefully.
What sort of size is the expo? How many square meters? I mean, in terms of the actual area that you put this.
So it is a lot of hectares. I mean, so it is very big. It is the in Astana. So in the city, we have the part of Astana of our city for Astana Expo. So it is like a lot of. A big territory, very big and very beautiful, very new buildings, very new parks, even we have buildings, I mean homes, hotels, just in this area.
Now, when I think of Kazakhstan, I think of clean air, I think of beautiful women, great food, and beautiful scenery as well.
Yeah.
These are some of the things that I think of. Now, in Astana just last year, in July, I believe, you had the cycling, the Tour de Astana.
Yeah.
How did that go? And is there a plan for a 2017 cycling event? Because you do have one of the best cycling teams in the world as well.
Yeah, yeah. Astana, you know it. I see that you know it. And we have, so we are trying to do our facilities, we are trying to do the city so it were, well, very comfortable. I mean, even for cycling, for everything, for everybody.
So next year there is a Tour de Astana again. Will you be looking at a Tour de Almaty as well, possibly extending it to that area?
So it will be just in Astana. But of course we would like, we have different tourist products, we have different recommended by Expo tourist products. I mean, not only in Astana, but when tourists will come to Astana Expo, we hope that, and we will, so people will go to also to Astana, Burabay, it is Akmola region, also to Almaty, also to Mangistau, to southern Kazakhstan. So we have different routes and different tourist products.
What is your biggest challenge to increase visitor arrival numbers? What is the hardest part for Kazakhstan to get people to know about it so that they come? What's the hardest challenge for you?
So the challenge, like I told you, the biggest one for now, the tourism just starts to develop. And for now, as for a young country, only 25 years old country, the first target, of course, to promote Kazakhstan, to attract a lot of people so that Kazakhstan will be the best country in the world.
One of the best countries. What do you think is the ideal vacation period, let's say, for somebody coming to Kazakhstan?
I guess
Kazakhstan.
It is from May. I mean, but it depends, again, if you like the frost, I mean, minus 30, minus 25, you can come in the winter, I mean, you can come in December, you can come in February, in January, but the best it is when the nature wakes and everything is beautiful. The best it is from May till September.
What is the average length of stay at the moment for leisure travelers compared to business travelers?
So if it is leisure, it is 7 days, 10 days. If it is business, it's 3-4 days, 5 days maximum.
In Almaty, in Astana, I've noticed that it's not necessarily easy to get a taxi sometimes. There's a lack of infrastructure for tourists in that in that aspect.
Okay.
Are you trying to increase the number of car rental and taxis available in the tourist cities such as Almaty and Astana?
So, of course, the number of taxis of cars increases year by year. And as I told you again, we're trying to change the infrastructure so to help people so to be easier to move in the country. I guess taxis, so you can go outside and you can stop just the car and it stops and it's okay. And you can show, you can call, I mean, to the taxi, to the telephone, and it's okay.
Tourism is just growing, it's just starting. It's like a little baby in Kazakhstan at the moment.
You
can mold it however you like. Which countries do you look at and study and say, yes, we'd like what they've done in their country and we want our tourism industry to grow in the same way? Who do you look at? Which countries do you watch?
So, as I told you, the first markets, it is Asian countries for us, first of all. I mean, like Japan, like China, Russia, of course, and of course Europe, like, Germany, the best travelers, one of the best travelers also, like UK. So we target all the world.
And Janet, my last question for you. I've been to Almaty a few times, I've been to Astana a few times. Like I said, I love Kazakhstan. But I'm sure that when you go on holiday, you go to somewhere I've never even heard about.
Yes.
Where would you go for 1 week, just to get away, to relax, no telephones, no nothing, just to enjoy the scenery and the relaxing area? Where would you go on holiday in Kazakhstan?
Kazakhstan.
Yes,
so,
where in Kazakhstan?
Yeah. Kazakhstan, I will go outside the Almaty region. I can go to southern Kazakhstan. And I can go to northern Kazakhstan.
And where's your favorite part? Just one place. Just pick one place.
Almaty region.
Almaty region.
Yeah,
and because it is a very big region as well, isn't
it? Yeah.
So I'm trying to narrow you down here a little bit, Janet. Where exactly in Almaty region would you go?
Charin Canyon, Turgen Valley, mountains, Shimbulak, let's say in Kazakh. Very beautiful places to stay and to go to.
I think I should make a note of those names and watch their growth in the future.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, Janet, thank you very much indeed for
your
time today. And of course, I wish you and Kazakhstan the best of luck for the future.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.